Cumulus. Sometimes these guys are your best mates, other times they're your worst enemy. They look a little bit like cauliflowers and they're formed when the weather is warm enough to allow water vapour to pile up on top of itself into a big heap. And in fact, that's what the Latin name cumulus means. Cumulus humulus, aka the humble cumulus, are usually formed when the weather is absolutely gorgeous. They're called fair weather cumulus for a reason, and they're often the best kind of clouds to spot shapes in, you know, rocket ships, animals, dogs, faces, you name it. Cumulus are formed by convection, which is the same process that makes the top of a building warmer than the bottom. And it's the same process that produces lots of little bubbles that go up and down in a boiling saucepan. So on a nice summer's day, the sun's radiation will heat up the ground and also the little layer of air just above it. So as that air warms up, it will start to rise and it will go up through the atmosphere. As it does that, it will cool down, and once it gets to a specific threshold, all the water vapour in that air will condense out into lots of tiny little water droplets, and that's what forms the cloud. Convection is that process that gives those cumulus clouds their height, but also that distinctive pile shape. On really hot, humid days, those lovely little cumulus clouds can turn nasty, or at least wet. As the process of convection gets going, those humble cumulus turn into towering monsters. They get taller and taller and taller and develop an anvil at the top, making them wider at the top than at the bottom. That's when we call them a cumulonimbus, a thunderstorm cloud. Inside the cloud, the little tiny water droplets get bigger and bigger and bigger and can turn into gigantic raindrops or even hail. We see that from the ground as a darkening at the bottom, and that's how you can always tell one's going to rain on you. Because they're so tall, cumulonimbus clouds can develop an electrical charge difference between the top and the bottom of the cloud, and that is what causes thunder and lightning. They're also associated with these really intense downpours of rain that can provide much needed relief on those hot, sticky summer afternoons.